Let's cover the news from the weekend. Let's talk about what's going on in the world of Hero Wars.
It's only a game. Why you have to be mad?
Nothing really new has popped off today, specifically today, but we're going to start with Hero Wars Mobile. We got the full view of what the spooky skins, demonic skins, excuse me, are going to look like. This is for Hero Wars Alliance. We have Mushy and Shroom, Amira, and Julius. Of course, we've known this for a little while. Amira and Mushy and Shroom are getting magic attack. Julius is getting physical attack. This is why Julius's green ability was or is changed as of today. We're going to have to do some testing today and throughout the week and see how effective or ineffective it is. I think that it'll be okay, everybody. I think that it'll be okay. Now, we don't know yet when these skins are going to go live, right? It hasn't really given us much information. We're still a good ways off from Halloween here in the United States and across the world. But we did get the announcement today that they are going to have another Halloween cosplay or costume contest. I will once again attempt to dress up like Kark, even though he's not good. He's not probably a good person to dress up as a costume, and he's really not that good on Hero Wars Mobile either. Hero Wars Alliance, excuse me. But there's some great rewards here. First place is 125,000 emeralds, a skin plus of your choice, 3 hero skins of your choice, 25 million gold. That's pretty serious stuff, right? And I would imagine anybody that enters will get something. Anybody that enters will get something. So I can probably dress up, paint my face a little bit to look like Anvari or Astrid or something and get something, though I don't plan on it actually. Now, if there's a costume contest for Facebook and web, I will dress Remy up like the new pet, which is probably going to be a spider. The new pet's probably going to be a spider. We have an artifact chest discount that's live. We have an artifact chest discount that's live on Hero Wars Alliance as well. 55% discount on this bad boy. I like this chest. I don't like it as much as the Outland chest discount or the Big Money Blue Ball chest discount. Though, you know, I'll take it. I don't like how they're kind of cycling through these right now. We had a couple of days ago, we had the Elemental Sphere event. Like I said, Big Money Blue Ball. And I would expect to, in the next day or two, maybe the next week or so, I would expect to see some kind of heroic chest discount. I did want to check today to see if the Tristan skin has been added. Let's see, rewards list, grand prizes. Yeah, the Tristan skin has yet to be added. I thought it was going to be added today, but I guess I read that wrong. When is that Tristan skin going to be added to the heroic chest? Let's see. Solar skin's released. So October 11th. Okay, so 2 more days, the Tristan skin will be added. Very cool. Very cool. I would imagine that in the next 2 days, like I said, because this is being added, this guy right here is being added to the heroic chest, we're going to see that 55% discount. It's going to be a tenth item, a 10th grand prize, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It's going to be a 10th grand prize, which is okay. But the problem is you can get the... you can get the soul coins multiple times, right? So if you open up enough chests to get the grand prize, and let's see, there's 400. So let's see, if we have 1,500 emeralds for the 10, and then we need to multiply that by 40, right? Yeah, that's 60,000 emeralds, and then we take 55% off times 0.45. That's 27,000 emeralds. Okay, so each grand prize is going to be guaranteed at 27,000 emeralds. You multiply that by 10, assuming you only get the soul coin one time. That's 270,000 emeralds now to get them all. There's a huge list of heroes in Hero Wars Alliance that will get super skins or skin pluses added to the heroic chest. Any hero that already has 5 skins, for example, you have Astaroth here. Any hero that has 5 skins that does not have a super skin yet will eventually have a skin plus likely added to the heroic chest. Okay, and this is going to be added over time. We don't have any other events that are live right now on Hero Wars Mobile, and Lode Runner hasn't really given us any kind of leaks as far as upcoming events coming to Hero Wars Mobile. I keep saying that, Hero Wars Alliance, you guys know what I mean. So I don't really know what's going on. I don't know if they're gearing up for a bunch of fun stuff for Halloween. I don't know. Julia Shield changed today. Did anyone notice changes in Julia Shield? Yeah, anybody that wants to chime in with some feedback about Julius's shield, that'd be great. I'd appreciate it. Or if you want to send me some fight information before and after, to Discord. I'd be happy to share them. Happy to share them here. Mort Hangover. Yeah, yeah. Just finished up the Mort event for sure. Now over on Hero Wars Dominion Era, the seasonal adventure, The Mysterious Island, was added to the game on Saturday. We had a broken reward from the Valkyries for the first day. This didn't work, but it does work now. So if you clicked on this and you didn't get the reward, go back to the official Facebook page for Hero Wars Dominion Era and click on this and get that reward. The Light and Darkness Titan event started, which we knew that was going to happen. We're going to talk more about that in just a second. And then we had the cosmic battle ending, and there we go. Now, I actually had a pretty good ranking in the cosmic battle. I did okay. I didn't get, that high. I didn't get like top 50 or anything like that because, I'm not a pay-to-win player. But I did do okay. I got a bunch of rewards. Pretty happy about it. I spent a lot of stuff, bought a lot of items. Very much looking forward to finishing leveling up some stuff. The cool thing about the triple dipping, like we talked about triple dipping for the pet season, buy the golden ticket for the pet season on the last day of the Path of the Warrior event to triple dip with the Color of the Night and the Shining Ascension. I do want to point this out, this huge error in the file here. I'm sorry, a huge error in the task description. You can see upgrade a Titan skin 2 times for the Color of the Night. And over here on the Light Titan one, it was upgrade a Light Titan skin. So they did mess this up. This should be upgrade a Darkness Titan skin, not a Light, not any Titan skin, but a Darkness. Huge mistake here. This is not the first time that this mistake has happened for this event. It's unfortunate. It's a shame. I mentioned it to the community managers yesterday. They still haven't fixed it. I don't know what's going to happen with it. I don't know. I think that it's a huge problem. I think that they need to quality control some of their stuff a little better. Yeah. The avatar situation up here in the top left is going to be fixed for me in the very near future. And I wanted to tell you that if you did not get the triple dipping for buying the golden ticket, there's another opportunity to, if you just couldn't afford it or you weren't interested in it or whatever, you will have another opportunity to triple dip on the 10th, which is tonight. Okay, you'll have a little bit of a window so you can see that the Color of the Night event and the Shining Ascension event ends in basically a day and a half. In 11-ish hours, the event, Foundations of Power does go live. And Foundations of Power is a pretty good event for Titan Skin Stones, though it's a low return on investment. Foundations of Power, here we go. It's skewed, actually. I don't like how it's skewed because it is a very rare material, Titan Skin Stones. But there is a buy emeralds task right here, not buy VIP. So if you are going to do some spending, and specifically if you buy the subscriptions, right, which was added to the game, then you might be able to triple dip, once more. I'm taking a look at this post on the 13th, very likely to get an emerald sale along with the Time of the Fearless, like a 1 day. I'm thinking this is probably going to be a 5x right here, but we won't know for sure until that happens. If you wait until then, it will be too late. Yeah. Yeah. Now, the main thing that you would be considering to buy right now, if not the golden ticket, because the golden ticket doesn't actually give you any emeralds, right? Counts towards the Foundations of Power event. They did add these subscriptions right here, the resource subscriptions. This is a new feature that they're trying out because of the Mysterious Island edition. Mysterious Island is a cool little thing that we have. A lot of great people in the community working on maps for this. But here's kind of the breakdown of the entire map. There's a lot missing up here in the top left. There's definitely some opportunity for this to be opened up. And there's a lot of things that we don't know yet, like what does the November season look like? Is it going to be the same as the pet season as far as the moves that you can get and unlock? Will there be more free moves here and there? If you have not already, go to herowarcentral.com and check out this blog post for the best paths, the best free-to-play paths. There's a lot of other paths that you can take, a lot of different paths that you can take. But if I'm not mistaken, there's 129 total locations, and you will need to purchase this guy right here, right? 8 weeks at 2 a day is 112, plus the 50 that you get, 40 to 50 or whatever it is that you get for the golden ticket for pet season in order to get all of the locations. Mysterious Island has no totem fragment. Maybe they add in upper, maybe they add the totem fragment in there. It's very possible. The grand prize, grand prize. There's actually several grand prizes. If you took a look right here, there's a legendary gift of the Dominion, right? You can rank a hero up from orange 4 to red 0. There's a 30,000 emerald, a 10,000 emerald, a 10,000 emerald, 60,000 Titan skin stones, 10,000 of the whatever that currency is. I keep forgetting what it's called. There's a lot of grand prizes on the map already. And, you know, it would be potentially beneficial for you to purchase to get these items. It is a good value, but should you or should you not, that's going to be entirely up to you and your budget, right? If you are a spender on this game, it is a good value. And if you're going to buy the subscription, you might as well get the best value, this one right here, because you don't know what next month is going to look like. If they're going to open up all of this up here, you might want the extra moves early on. You know, it's kind of hard to say. But if you are going to buy a subscription and you haven't bought a subscription yet, if you haven't bought a subscription, then you should wait until the Foundations of Power event goes live in 12 hours. 9 hours if you're a web player, 12 hours if you are a Facebook player. All right, you can triple dip again because you are buying emeralds here, right? So you will get credit for that as well as the VIP credit, okay? Thank you, Essence of the Elements, thank you. I've been saving up my moves a little bit, haven't used too much, still not 100% sure what I'm planning on doing yet. I don't know if I'm gonna buy a subscription or not. Haven't figured it out, haven't decided on it. We'll plan that out probably a little bit later today. Deorman says, what does everyone think of this? I'm sure you're asking about the Mysterious Island thing. I'm really enough in My Heroes Care that the subscription is beneficial with lots of resources, but this does not emphasize the pay-to-win element. But this does emphasize the pay-to-win element. Yeah, so it is going to be impossible for you to get anywhere near all of these resources unless you buy a subscription, right? Not only do you have to buy the golden ticket, which is $45, but you also have to buy the subscription. And this one right here, two times, let's see, that's 56 moves. You get 5 for free up here, puts you at 61. And then you get the 40 or whatever, you're only going to get about 100, 110 moves if you don't buy the big subscription. And then assuming that this top part of this island opens up, which, you know, I'm sure it is. If you take a look at the map, all of this space up here, you can't access. Assuming that opens up, there's going to be more stuff up there. You're going to have to buy another golden ticket for another $45. That's a lot of money. That's $90 worth of golden tickets plus the $60 for the subscription. $150 to get all these rewards. $150. Now, a lot of people have done math. I'm not going to do the math, but a lot of people have done the math that even with that, it's still better than the best emerald sale as far as the resources that you get. It's a lot of different resources, but it's only worth getting if you can double and triple dip those VIP tasks, right? Buying the 8-week subscription is better than the golden ticket. Buying it now will give you 140,000 emeralds. Best offer on emeralds for free, pay to play and pay to win. Let's see. With 8-week subscription plus past season, post pet season, golden ticket, you can get entire map. Okay. I wonder if this is a 3-month map. It's a 2-month map, Kurt. It says that it expires in 55 days right here. So it's only a 2-month map. Skip the golden ticket. So everybody's saying to not buy the pet golden ticket. I guess that makes sense. Like, what are you really getting out of the pet golden ticket anyway? Like, I know that it's worth getting, but the grand prize in here being the, here we go, the gift of the sanctuary. I'm liking all of the chaos particles, honestly. There's so many good chaos particle piles in here, ascension materials. Like, for me, because the new pet is coming soon, I think that it's worth it for me. But again, I have a budget that I'm spending on this game, and not everybody does.